Sir, I start from what from where the Honourable Minister left. In this supplementary demand for grants for the Union Territory of JNK, 8,820.62 crores have been allocated. Now, this amount itself, this pitiable amount, exposes the hollow claim of this government to develop the valley. And I'm sure the minister knows that what the Jammu, the Kashmir Chamber of Commerce Industry said, that since the removal of 370, economic loss of more than 10,000 crores have happened. I'm sure you have forgotten that, but it is the statement of Jammu Kashmir Chamber of Commerce that economic loss of 10,000 crores. Sir, I am not yielding, sir. I am not yielding. No, sachchai chupti hai mujhe malum. Now, coming to this another point, disinvestment. I want to know from the Honourable Minister that the disinvestment target was 1,05,000 crores. You have only realized 17%, sir, as of now. 17%. Thirdly, sir, I strongly oppose this infusion in IDBI bank to recapitalization bonds. IDBI is a black box. LIC is a piggy bank. And this government had forced LIC in January 2019 to spend 21,000 crores to buy 51% of IDBI. Now, why IDBI? Is because of scams of Sivasankaran. You know, you are not able to pay the compensation of states, rightful share of the states in GST, which is constitutionally mandated, but you are so much interested in IDBI. I don't know why. I mean, what is there in IDBI that the states cannot get their share of compensation? I strongly oppose this, sir, of giving infusion of IDBI of 4,557 crores. Fourth point, sir, I want to know how the finance minister, when she replies, the revenue collection April 2019 to October 19, that is 7 months period, government collected 9.3 lakh crores. Now, the budget estimated is of 20.8 lakh crores in 1920. What magic wand do you have that you will collect this remaining amount? Because last year, sir, in the same period, the amount collected was 11.5 lakh crore from November 11.5 lakh crore has to be collected. Now you come to the center net tax revenue, sir. To meet the budget targets, government needs to collect 9.7 lakh crore in the period November 19 to March 2020. In the same five-month period last year, the government could collect only 6.6 lakh crore. Who are you fooling? Well, now it is 4.5, last year 6.6 lakh. Now you are saying from November to March 2020, you are going to collect 9.7 lakh crore in center net tax revenue. Corporation tax, sir. The budgetary targets, government is to collect 4.9 lakh crore from November to March 2020. Same time last year, you only collected 3.9 lakh crore. These are data. I know you don't like the truth, but data. Income tax, sir. To meet the target, the government needs to collect 3.2 lakh crore in the period from November 19 to March 2020. In the same period last year, sir, this revenue collection only 2.3 lakh crore. Now, come to GST, sir. To meet the budget target of government needs to collect 3.2 lakh crore in the period from November 19 to March 2020. In the same period last year, you could collect only 2.5 lakh crore. Now, you are saying you will collect 3.2 lakh crore. And you are also foregoing 4.5 lakh crore in corporation tax. I want to know, are you going to go to the World Bank and beg for this revenue shortfall, or again you're going to fall on LIC to make up your revenue shortfalls and dressing up your fiscal deficit? That is the point, sir. Now, LIC, sir, when the Modi government came to power, LIC, since the inception of 1956, the cumulative investment in public sector was 11.9 lakh crore. Mubarak ho aapko, fantastic, you've done a great job. At the end of financial 2018-19, it jumped to 22.6 lakh crore. I mean, from 56 to 2014, it was 11.9 lakh crore, and within 6 years, you have utilized LIC as 10.7 lakh crore. Amazing, sir. Now, last point, sir, about the terms of reference of 15th Finance Commission, sir. This is a very strong point, sir, I want to make over here. That how is it that the terms of reference of the 15th Finance Commission, the government is saying that defense and internal security allocation will be looked into. You are violating the fiscal federalism. What has the state got to do with the defense expenditure? It is the union government. What has the state got to do with sharing of this security aspect, sir? Allocation of defense is the union responsibility. That is why I said, again, the spirit of parliamentary control over expenditure allocation, sir. I hope that when the Honorable Minister stands up, she will definitely talk about the question which I have put to her. And lastly, I'm really surprised that you say your minority minister made a public statement that when it comes to minorities, everyone will get a 1 lakh people will get, 10 lakh people will get scholarship, 5 lakh. What is there? You have cut down 180 crores from pre-matric, post-matric, merit come means, and all these scholarships. So what you are saying is not matching up by your budgetary allocation, sir. I end by saying, lamhon ne khata ki, sadiyon ne saza paayi.